Okay, Amanda's got me on here as a guest, but I might be a regular. We want to show you how we did this RV thing, where we got it, how we renovated it, where we went. So we're going to kick off this journey.
No, wait, come back.
Hi, if you know me, I'm always down for adventure and always have a crazy idea. My latest? Renovate an RV and live in it full time for the summer. This is my crew. Este es mi gente. Come road tripping with our family.
Hey guys, I'm so glad you're here. We are going to share with you our crazy RV adventure. Honestly, it was an adventure with ups and downs, but it was so worth it. We had so much fun. We want to share with you all the behind the scenes of renovating our RV. How do you do that?
No.
It took us a long time to decide on which trailer we wanted. We looked at a bunch and we decided, you know what, we're just going to have to pick one and go with it, even though we were so indecisive and couldn't decide which one we should get.
So we decided on this beauty, the Salem Forester 27 footer.
We just got our travel trailer. I'm so excited. Excited for this new project. Can't wait to get started.
We took it to Demi, New Mexico, stripped it, made it so clean.
Yeah, so the first thing we did was we stripped everything. We took all the junk out. It had a really bad smell.
It stunk bad.
Yeah, it smelled really bad. So we took everything out. Had to scrub down the walls, even like the curtains. We took out the sofa that was in there, the table, everything.
And took out everything. Now it's time to sand. We've been sanding everything down and making sure that everything is ready to paint. My least favorite part of painting is sanding.
So much of what we did was trial and error. We are not professionals. We had no idea what we were doing.
It's pretty much like arts and crafts. So many weird corners and angles, and the bathroom floor was like 2 square feet. Like, how do I do this?
Pat, I'm trying to fix it.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know how to fix it. Daddy has no idea.
Oh. But in a daddy. Three! Four! One more!
There you go.
Please, buddy.
Thank you. I'm making a dinosaur!
You're making a dinosaur? Good job.
One of the custom additions that we did was the baby bunks in the bedroom. What I did was I just sketched an idea of what I wanted on quill papers, and then I showed it to my baby bro, and he carpeted.
Elder Quintana.
And he did an amazing job. We loved how they did that.
Good.
This is the bunk bed that our carpenter Coco is making for us.
Excited?
Pink, think Nico likes it.
Are you bumping your head?
Did I tell you about when the cabinet door fell on my head?
No, Kiko told me about it though.
It was
worried about you. I think I was in New York or something.
Yeah, that was insane. Usually I unscrew the cabinet and take it off. So I unscrewed one and then without thinking, like just lost in thought, went to the one directly below it without taking the cabinet door off. I took the screws off, but I didn't take the door off. Went to the one right beneath it and started working on that one.
Best was, I think, was your brother in the other room?
Yeah.
And you're like, ow, and he just like kept working.
No, no, he was like, that's
that's
but it didn't hurt. It was a miracle. It was the miracle of the mom bun, because I always have my hair in this mom bun. And the bun saved my head. It literally like fell right on the bun. What are the odds? So once everything was all prepped, then it came down to painting, and it took us a long time to paint. Luckily, I had a good paint crew to help me out.
Was I part of that crew?
You were there.
I laid down the initial coat.
You helped prime. Yeah, you did help prime. But
the painting. I said painting. There's a big one over there. Happy thing picture.
A happy picture? Yeah. See, I'm painting.
Yeah. Painting.
It looks so good.
Painting, Mama.
Oh yeah.
I'm painting high. I didn't paint up there.
You want to paint up high?
Yeah.
Mama already painted that part.
Oh, hey. Uh-huh. Paint that one, Mama.
You want me to paint with this one?
Yeah. I'm gonna paint that one.
Okay, you paint with that one. I'll paint with this one. Cheers.
After painting, Amanda had this brilliant idea. Let's put a fireplace in our RV. And she ordered one, and then I came back from work one weekend and the fireplace was waiting there for me, and I had to put it where the entertainment center was. So we removed the entertainment center, raised the table, I raised the countertop, popped the fireplace in. It was pretty sweet. And then we had to get power to it. Ended up being really cool though.
Yeah, I loved how it turned out. Much in the bathroom. I used contact paper to cover the counter, and the toughest part of the bathroom was the backsplash, because it was the tiniest, tightest area, and that stuff was sticky and not the easiest to work with.
Sticky stuff. Killed it on the countertop. Literally, I did not want to rip out all the countertops into the sink. This is a trailer. We're going to live in it for like 8 weeks or 7 weeks, whatever it was. So she came with this idea. Like, what is it called?
Contact paper.
And marble, and just sheet the whole thing.
Oh, you're talking about the kitchen.
Yeah, the kitchen.
Yeah.
Well, and the bathroom.
And that's true. I did do a different one in the bathroom.
But yeah, I had to do no plumbing, no ripping out sinks, just contact paper over it. And
yeah. It was surprisingly durable too.
Yeah, it worked out good.
So we got it to a point where there wasn't much more we could do in New Mexico, because we were going back and forth a lot from our home in Arizona to the ranch in New Mexico, and it was tough to get any progress because we weren't there a lot. So we decided that we would take the trailer back to our house in Arizona.
Well, that was going to be the starting point anyways.
True. The problem was we didn't have a ton of space.
No space at all.
Well, and it was funny because...
And HOA didn't like it.
The reason we liked that house that we got in Arizona was because it said it had an RV gate. But it was so tiny. Like, yeah. We literally had inches on either side of the trailer.
Seriously, check this out.
So we're a little crazy. We're trying to fit our trailer.
Yeah. So.
Oh man, this is a tight fit.
Yay, you win! You win this.
So we kept chipping away at it, but it was so tough because we had a newborn baby. She wasn't sleeping through the night, which meant I wasn't sleeping through the night. This guy was gone a lot for work. He was in New York or Florida all the time. And I'm just trying to get this trailer done. It was insane. So I was getting a little flustered.
A little. To say the least.
I'm not gonna lie. I'm a little stressed out. Brian's been gone to New York all week. And we're supposed to leave on Monday. And we have so much to do still. The trailer's not ready at all. Making progress. This is just a progress video. Hi, friends.
Good progress.
Look at all this progress.
Hey, don't spray that eagle, please.
Working until the last second. Somehow, miraculously, we got it all done.
Fresh. Check it out.
Because a lot of people were very concerned when they saw these baby bucks with like an open bunk on top where I was putting the baby, and everyone was so worried like she would fall out. Okay guys, I'm not gonna just throw my baby up there and like hope that she doesn't fall. I decided to go with hanging this net, so it made it a lot easier to put the baby up there, put the net up, and then let her sleep. It actually worked out really well.
Thank you. It's so funny.
What would you say percentage-wise?
Of what?
What you did versus what I did.
Oh, I don't know. That doesn't matter.
I know.
I know you were busy with work. Like,
No. Come on, give me like 10%.
No, you had more than that.
20%. I'll take 20%. Seriously, Amanda did most of it. It was...
No, you did the floors. I could not have done the floors and the fireplace. And you did like... Okay, so... This is next episode, but Brian was in charge of functionality.
Not need to talk about
making it look good. Oh, don't worry.
You're gonna drove it down the road. It might not have worked.
Trust me.
Stop one, but
you're gonna
we got close.
Next episode.
At the holidays.
Things are gonna get interesting.
It's almost bedtime, but tomorrow is our first time taking the RV out. So we're getting it ready, pulling it out from the backyard and getting ready for our first trip.
Feels like home to me. Feels like home to me. Feels like I'm
home. This is the scary part.
Just go slow, you're good.
Yep. Don't touch the window. With your, that's good. Good job.